Hi there, my name is Vadim Mikhailenko, and in this quick video we're going to learn about 7 key questions asked as part of Microsoft Excel interview tests. Plus, 1 bonus question, so stick with me to learn more. So let's take a look at the question, how to make the entire row bold or italic with different color. First of all, you need to understand the data you're looking at. We're looking at Microsoft Excel with the data that's already has been entered. We have multiple columns, A through F, and we have rows 1 through 9. And just by looking at the data, it shows some sales, right? These are the number items with the descriptions. And by categories, group by categories, and for multiple quarters, Q1 through Q4. So your question is how to make the entire row bold or italic with different color. Let's pick row number 5. And I think that's the good row for this. It's kind of in the middle and it will show. And you see, I just clicked on the row 5 and it selected the entire row to infinity. And that's the way to do it. You certainly can do it, but keep in mind that all the cells beyond F will also be selected with that particular formatting. So sometimes it makes sense just to select the area that you're interested in, A through F, but you probably need to make a determination how you want to do it based on the circumstances. So I highlighted row 5, and now what I'm going to do, now I can manipulate the data, and now I can change italic. And I can put bold here, right? And the instructions in the text ask us to do both. So that's what we're going to keep. And now there's a button here called font color. And that's what we're going to click. And then there are multiple colors here available. And you just pick the color that's most relevant and related. So maybe look at the header. And I think the related topic color might be this. Couple considerations when picking the color. You don't just pick how color looks on the screen. You also think how color will look at the printing, and most likely black and white printing. So that's probably the dark color is typically better, and that's typically a good choice. Now let's take a look at how you would make the entire row with a different background color. And the answer here is rather easy. You select the row, and again, multiple ways of selecting the row, right? You can do it this way, selecting just the required columns, or you can click on the entire row and select it to infinity. We're gonna select just the specific columns, and then you click on the background color, and you pick the specific color that you wanna highlight. This is the color of our header, so we probably want to pick a different one. So let's pick a different one, maybe from this palette. And that's it. Now let's take a look how you would create total for each quarters. First of all, you need to understand where the data is located, right? And we have columns C through F that represent quarterly sales data for different supplies. And these are the descriptions of the supplies. In order for you to create totals, what you need to do, you need to highlight the row below, next below row where numbers stop. And then the easiest way is just clicking Auto Sum button. And when you click it, what Excel does, it highlights the area on top, and Excel kind of does intelligence on its own, and it's tries to predict the area which you need to do a sum for, and you just need to hit enter, and it calculated the total. But if area needs to be different, for example, if you're doing it for this column and you need to change the area, you can do it manually also. I'm just pushing the left mouse button and dragging the selection area, and that selects the required area. Another way to do it is you can just copy the cell, and copy is this button, copy, and then we'll paste, and this will paste the entire formula from rows 2 through 9 for the column F, and I just click paste here. right? And it pasted the information. And these are the totals for all quarters individually. And what you might also want to do is just a nice thing to do. You just type total, and that's typically what you do. And you might also want to do extend the formatting for this grid. And the way to do it, you highlight the area where you want to add borders, and you just click here and select all borders, and that will maintain the formatting for the borders. Now let's take a look how you would create total for the entire year. And again, what we see here, we see a data for multiple quarters, Q1 through Q4, right? In order for us to calculate total for the entire year, we would want to add probably another column. So the easiest way would be just to copy this cell. And again, what we do is we click copy here and we click paste in this column. And we will rename it. The reason I did copy and paste it so it retained the formatting, and we'll just say year here, extend it a little bit so it matches size wise other columns. That's, I think, is important. And what we want to do, we want to use the sum function, but we want to use it first of all for every item here, and then we will do a total for each line item right here in this column, G10. So let's first do a sum for wireless chargers. And the way for us to do it, we'll click auto sum button, and Excel predicts the area that we want to do a sum for. But again, we can manually control it before we click enter. But I'm good with this. I'm going to click enter. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to make this a little bit bigger so we can see it. So probably need to do a zoom out a little bit. And now we have a number. So now we calculated for wireless chargers. We can do the same thing for Apple screen protectors. I'm gonna hit enter. Or we can just copy and look at this. We click the copy button, And now what I'm going to do, I'm gonna select this entire area right here, rows 4 through 9, and I'm just gonna click paste. So it pastes this value, this formula, right into this selection. And voila, it's all set. Now we have totals for a year for all different supplies and electronics, and we just need to calculate it for the year for the entire product lines that we're selling. And for that, we'll just click auto sum again. And again, we got such a big number that it doesn't fit, which is 148,839.43. So the only remaining thing would be to write total here to make it look nice, and also add the formatting. For that, we just highlight all the cells and we select all borders. Now let's take a look at how to sort data from largest to smallest. So in order to do that, you would need to select the entire area that you would like to sort. And in our case, it would be all the cells with the data. And then we're going to click the sort and filter button. And then we are going to select the custom sort. Custom sort allows us to sort by specific column. And in this case, it makes sense to sort by description. And that's exactly what we're going to choose. It also gonna sort on cell values. There are different ways of sorting. You can sort by cell color, font color, conditional formatting, and you can choose A to Z, you can choose Z to A, or you can even choose a custom list. So we're gonna just stick to default A to Z, and let's see what's gonna happen. Remember, wireless chargers are on the top, and we're sorting A to Z. Then goes Apple screen protector, voice remote. I just wanted you to pay attention here. Click the sort, and now we have all the items with their associated number, which is important. That's why we selected all the values in the grid from A to W. And A is Alexa, and then the second letter also goes in alphabetical order. So you can see all the sorted items here in the list, and I can definitely unselect it. Now let's take a look how you would group the data based on the categories. And the easiest way to do it is actually apply a filter. That's a very nice feature of Microsoft Excel. To do that, we can select the whole thing, or we can just select the first row, and we're gonna click Sort and Filter button, and we'll click Filter. And now, look, it added a very small drop-down buttons here, Microsoft Excel. And now look what happens when we click on this button. It shows us all the items, and if we want to remove something, we can just unselect all and select the ones that we want to look at, and that's what happens. Now, that's so cool. We can also clear the filter from description, that put it back. But grouping the data, in this case, makes sense for categories because there are only two categories. A lot of times there are a lot more categories, but in this case there are only two. So we will select, and let's say we only want to see data in electronics. We uncheck supplies, and that's what you see. You only see electronics, or vice versa. Maybe you want to see only supplies, and then you uncheck electronics and click supplies. Or maybe you want to see the whole thing, both electronic and supplies. And here you go. Now let's look at how you can insert a chart into Microsoft Excel. And the best way to do that, the best way to insert the chart is to select the entire area that you're trying to build a chart for. And then you go to Insert tab in the ribbon. And then you click a lot of chart choices, as you can probably imagine. But the good thing, Microsoft Excel recommends you the chart. So I clicked Recommended Chart. And this is the chart that Excel recommends. I kind of don't like it. So I'm going to scroll and see if there are other choices. And I like this one much, much, much better. So now I just click OK. And Excel inserts the chart. And I am going to make it full screen so you guys can see better. The cool thing about the chart, we can even overlap the table. And I am... To do it this way, I am going to zoom out a little bit and move the chart a little bit down, scroll down here. So we will see only chart. We will expand it a little bit here on the screen so we can see it, make it bigger. And what you see, this chart lists, we have different categories. We have our values, right? The sales values for quarters, and every bar represents every separate quarter. So for example, for HP Pavilion, we have Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, right? And this is highlighted right here. We can also change the chart title, and we can, for example, annual sales. And that shows us all the values that we would like to see. We can close this so it expands the whole chart. It will be available for printing, and you can modify it maybe if you want to not select categories next time to make it easier and more readable. You can certainly do that. Chart is built based on the values that you can highlight. And you can also delete the chart. You just need to select it. You see it selected, and then you click the delete button on your keyboard. And now let's take a look at how would you project a revenue increase of 7% quarter to quarter. So just think about it. We'll start with quarter one. So quarter two should show 7% increase from quarter one. Then quarter three would show 7% increase from quarter two. And quarter four, 7% increase from quarter three. How would you do that? So the easiest way, let's clear out this data, because this data is actuals and does not represent anything for us. We would need to use a formula. And formula in Excel, we just select the value and we click type equal sign. And we're going to say value for Q1 multiplied by 107. And why 107? 1 represents the previous value. We multiply just by 1, we'll get exactly 5700. But 0.7 is the 7% increase for the Q1 value. And we're going to hit enter, and that's exactly what it's going to be. Now I'm going to copy this value, and I'm going to select the area where I want to paste this formula, and that's exactly where I'm going to paste it. And it will calculate Q2 now, 7% increase in all categories from Q1. Now, the cool thing about Excel, and look at this, I'm going to copy this whole thing, and now I can paste it in Q3 and Q4, and it will calculate a relative formula. Now Q3 would be calculated against Q2, and Q4 will be calculated against Q3. Just look at that. Here you go. So you don't need to do it one by one. Obviously you could, and you can retype the whole formula, but because of the power of Excel, we can project the Q1 through Q2, Q2 through Q3, and Q3 through Q4. That's the power of relative formulas in Microsoft Excel. Hope you have learned something and enjoyed this video. Make sure to click the subscribe button to stay in touch with me on YouTube. And join my email list so I can share with you more information about my free training courses. Hope to see you back soon. Again, this is Vadim Mikhailenko. Thanks again for watching.